When I was 6 years old, my grandmother took us out to the desert to look for wildflowers. Just where you'd think nothing in the world could grow, that's where they were. Grandma told us that those were her favorites, the ones that could grow in the hardest places. I was 9 when Mama married Jack. We were always moving after that, one desert town after another. And so I saved things. Remembering was my way of making things matter.
Better. Worse. Better. Worse.
Las Vegas was a small desert town in 1950. There was nothing but some hotels and casinos and the Air Force Base. I knew every inch of it, but my glasses made everything look different. Including, I hoped, me. I had a theory that glasses would make me look like Ingrid Bergman. Vegas is a glamorous town, and with my new glasses, I thought I'd fit right in. I loved movies, books, Wonder Woman, and my grandmother. Real life was another matter. That year, my stepfather had a gas station on the edge of town, the last stop before 400 miles of desert.
Daddy?
A man is 100 yards due south of a bear. He walks 100 yards due east, faces due north, fires his gun due north. He hits the bear.
What color is the bear?
bear.
You heard it before.
Nope.
We were at war in Korea, and the town was filling up with thousands of men in suits and uniforms, all headed out to the desert. No one knew why they came or what they were doing.
Right in there.
Where you fellas headed?
Out to the gunnery range.
There've been a lot of you fellas through here lately. You like desert country, huh? You got something going out there, huh? Something to do with Korea? Yeah, a good buddy of mine was wounded at Changjin a couple weeks ago. Guess you guys didn't figure the Chinese coming in, huh?
Hi, Mr. Chismore.
Hello, Robin.
Can I put some air in my tires?
Yeah, go ahead.
Thanks.
Hi, Robin.
Hi, Rose. Hey, Mr. Chismore, you need any help today?
Yeah, you sweep the bays, Robin. I'll give you a quarter.
Gee, thanks.
You look like science types.
I'm not in a position to say.
I bet you coked the Jewish. No offense. I can spot any nationality coming. The government's building some kind of defense plan out there. That's why all these science types. I read quite a bit. You know, True Magazine, the Great Thinker series. I keep up on things. I got an idea what you'd be making out there.
Come on, Jim, we're
Jets.
Leaving.
All right. Scientists.
Well, they couldn't figure out the bear puzzle. I asked them. Well, I got them. What do you think?
They're cute. Well, I think they look dumb.
You don't know anything about fashion, do you?
Mom's here.
Hi, girl.
I felt the glasses gave me mystery and cheekbones.
Where's Rose?
Well, she's in the bathroom.
Rosalie, I'm home.
How was school today?
Hi, Mama.
Hi, sweetheart.
How do you like working at the Cortez?
I'm in the hotel part. Hold on this one, sweetie, will you? Pays more than the palace did. People seem real nice, too. Matching sailor suits. All good things come in threes. Mwah.
Mama had a way of not seeing things sometimes. But she tried to make up for it with her cooking.
Dinner's ready. In bed, lights out by 8:30.
And no radio until you finish the dishes. Okie dokie?
Okie dokie.
Okay. Hey, sweet girls.
Okay.
And I'll be back soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
And you're going to get it.
Oh, shut up.
No.
very good.
Heavy air and gunnery activity continues tonight over Nellis Air Force Base, Las Vegas, in southern Nevada. The emergency air exercises were ordered by President Truman to bolster defenses in the western United States in the event of a Soviet attack. In Korea, sea evacuations of the battered U.S. 10th Corps began this...
Daddy? Yoo-hoo!
I'm right here.
Where are all the lights at?
I don't know.
You don't know? Well, who turned them out?
I did. Needed a break, that's all.
No rest for the weary.
I got the results back from the doctor today. He says I'm fine.
That's good.
He'd like you to come in for a checkup.
My great thinker's book come today?
No, no, not yet. Jack, maybe he can find out what's wrong.
What'd you tell him about me?
I only went because I... know how much you want a baby of your own. Jack.
Honey. Yoo-hoo. Daddy?
Three countries of Asia and Africa should fall into to Soviet Russia, we would lose.
Gorgeous hopes you go away. I can't think of anything to say.
Oh, Ron, knowing what to say is the easiest part. But do you come here?
Dirty dishes.
I'll get it in the
I don't want anybody to go in the car.
It's late, honey.
Yes, I know. It's late. It's late.
I have to go.
Oh,
Yes, you can. Concentrate. Remember when Daddy burned down the trailer in Barstow? Grandma sent force then, didn't she? In that time of grave work. Remember? So we'll go to Grandma's this Christmas. We'll ride Blackie and feed the chickens. We'll drink hot milk at night before we go to bed. And Star will be there and we'll have a lot of fun. The safest place in the whole world is behind the stove at Grandma's.
No, I won't come to bed.
How do you spell perceive? Remember I before E?
Who left the dirty dishes? Did you leave them out, Rose? Answer me. Answer me!
Get up. God damn it. Get out of bed.
You'll see him and you'll prove your memory. Here, clean it. Clean it up. Clean it up. You think you're too good to do the dishes? Is that it? You'd rather have your mother do them?
No, sir.
Then why didn't you do them?
I did most of them.
Most of them? That's what you're supposed to do? Most of them?
No, sir.
You think you can do them all, or is that too much to ask?
I can do all of them.
Well, thank you very much.
We have a visitor, Mr. Brandel, and he's going to tell us all about civil defense and then take us to the fun room where we'll have our blood tested.
I don't have any blood.
That winter, Mama's younger sister, Star, came to stay with us. Star had been a model in Miss Winnemucca, Nevada, and my favorite aunt.
Must be the place. Jack's always got to have the biggest antenna in town.
You want me to carry these in for you?
Thanks.
Now, class, what is Eric doing wrong?
Everything. He's not covering his head.
That's right. That's very important. Now, remember, first duck, then cover.
Name?
Rose Chismore.
Right, Tony? Duck and cover.
Name?
Shall I spell?
If you don't duck and cover, you could get hurt. It could knock you down, or throw you against a tree or a wall. It's such a big explosion, it could smash in buildings and break windows all over town.
And don't forget, kids, don't look at the flash.
My God, you've grown, girl.
A human being, Paul.
You wait till you fill out a little, and then we'll see what they say. Your glasses look real nice, honey.
And very sophisticated. Come on with me. I'm redecorating.
Let's see. Well, there we go. You just missed your dad, honey. He was helping me move some things around. Put that out of the hanger
for me, honey, will you?
He hates me.
He doesn't hate you, Rose. I don't suppose it's easy being stepdad to three girls.
Guess not.
Most men wouldn't try.
I know. That's my girl. Where's Uncle Frank?
Your Uncle Frank and I are, getting divorced.
But why?
Not now, honey, okay?
I'll never see him again, will I? Does Grandma know? Uncle Frank will call before your 42 days are up. I bet he will.
No, honey, he won't call. 42 days, huh? Boy, they sure do things quick in this town, don't they?
I don't like Frank anymore.
Don't say that, Rose. You know, your Uncle Frank's a nice guy.
Hello, Robin.
Hey, who was the best general? Eisenhower, MacArthur.
Patton was the best. He drove right by me in his Jeep once. Georgie, we called him. I said, it's okay, boys. Georgie's here. He got out, walked right next to me. BS like a regular guy, Patton. Jesus, it was cold. The Germans had the 101st pinned down at Bastogne. If they break through, they might win the war. 50 miles a day we made, through snow up to our waists. Supply had a parachute in our gas and ammo, we moved so fast. No army ever moved like the third. Crowds thought we were the dogs of hell. French girls, well, you're too young for that. It's history, Robin. We caught the Germans at Bastogne. We stopped them. When they asked us to surrender, we told them nuts. It was our greatest moment. Now the commies have taken everything anyway. Everything we fought for.
Communists have the 10th pinned down at Hungnam Beach right now.
I know. They should let MacArthur use the A-bomb like in Japan.
That's it. Look. There you go. Okay.
Well, look at this. How are my girls?
Fine.
You getting any heavier, Barbara Jo? Let me test this here. Let's see what's going on. Oh, my God. Big. Must be carrying a lot of money. Carrying a lot of money? It's in your ear. Look. Look at that. In your ear. How'd I do that here? That's for you. I don't have anything for you girls.
That's okay.
Look at what I got here. Oops. Something in my stomach. It's for Deanne. There you go.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, dear. Thank you. Here's something for you, Rose. This is the stamps you wanted.
Thank you.
Dinner in a jiffy, Daddy.
Company dismissed.
Don't I get anything, Jack?
Cover girl we got here.
I want you girls to be extra nice to Star. She's been through a terrible ordeal.
Rose.
By your hand, we all are fed, and we thank you, Lord, for our daily bread. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Going out tonight, I see. It's my first date. He's a real nice guy. I met him at the divorce line in the courthouse. It's a great place to meet men.
Well, you think that's a proper dress for a first date?
Gosh, I hope not. What do you think I'm wearing it for?
Well, you can attract a man with a dress like that, but he won't stick around long after he gets what he's after.
You know what?
Hmm?
Did a blood test at school today.
Oh, don't talk about blood at the table, sweetheart. You should see all the science types down at the Cortez.
They're putting in a big defense plan. I heard some men on the divorce line talking about it.
Well, if you ask me, they're just trying to figure out a system to beat the house. Oh, they do stand around at the tables gambling all day.
I know what they're doing.
What?
Heard on a short wave from out on the gunnery range. I'm not at liberty to say what it was. It's classified information. Top secret.
Oh, they don't put top secret information on the shortwave, do they, where anyone can hear?
My antenna is bigger than Kino's. I can hear everything. Didn't even put it in code. Should have put it in code. And when did the Russians get our secrets?
Well, can't you tell us anything about it, Daddy?
Yeah, Daddy, please.
Wild horses wouldn't drag it out of me, Jack.
Jack, you promised.
Well, what is it? Promise what?
We have some bats.
Bats?
Oh, my goodness.
It's okay, Star.
They're hairy, and they have big white teeth.
Well, don't open the door,
Daddy, no.
Jack.
Don't get in.
Close the door.
Figure some plan of attack against these bats. Maybe traps of some sort. Pellets. Poison pellets.
They are dirty, diseased animals. A little boy died in Reno.
It was plague from feeding the squirrels. Bats don't carry plague. They carry rabies. Remember, your squirrels carry plague, your bats carry rabies.
You hear that, girls? Your daddy says stay away from squirrels.
Okay.
That was rats, wasn't it, that carried the plague?
Squirrel's just a rat with a bushy tail. Look it up.
He's handsome. He must be rich.
Of course he's rich. You'd be rich, too, if you owned the biggest ranch in Texas.
He does?
Sally Haskell. Merrill Mosel. Stephen Sader. Shelley Spaulding.
I ate unde air sway. I may inte inky pay. Ute erne is k a oibe. One arme atwe.
You know you're smarter when you stand on your head, because all the blood goes to your brain. You never forget something when you learn it standing on your head. And it's good for your complexion, too.
Stop correspondent, Sally.
Not yourself, Smarty. Besides, Mrs. Mertori isn't going to let you take that spelling test standing on your head.
I think the Pink Pinky Club should volunteer for the Red Cross class. All in favor, say aye.
I just thought we weren't supposed to kiss boys.
Well, don't you want to help humanity and save people from the communists?
I guess so.
Okay, all in favor, say aye.
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 Aye. Hi, everybody.
Hey, Spitz.
Hi, honey.
Did you hear about the A-bomb?
What A-bomb?
Got a hunch. Bet a bunch. I see your dime and raise you 25. I was there when they made the announcement. You don't think the A-bomb would scare away the gamblers, do you, Daddy?
Nope.
What A-bomb?
He knew all about it. Way before they made the announcement, didn't you, honey?
Well, Las Vegas is in the
what
news
announcement?
Again today. Officials of the Atomic Energy Commission unveil plans to detonate atomic weapons on the bombing and gunnery range north of Las Vegas. The test will be unannounced and conducted in strict secrecy. Government scientists chose the remote desert test site after extensive studies proved atomic testing would not harm area residents. In fact, the commission says Las Vegas residents won't be able to see, feel, or hear the test. But you don't have to wait for the A-bomb to catch a great show in Las Vegas.
I got fives.
The fabulous Mills
and
brothers
queens.
Are singing nightly.
Kings and eights. Read them and we.
Now,
Paradise is wired.
It's your deal, honey.
Bye.
Yeah.
He knew about it way before they even made the announcement. Didn't you? Didn't you, Daddy? Good night. Lights out.
Father Joe, put the dog tags back on.
I need to wear them at night.
Do you think A-bombs only go off in the daytime?
I'm scared. I can't sleep.
I'm not. I'll kick that A-bomb if it ever comes around here.
Will not.
Shh. Go to sleep. Stop being silly.
Now I know why they gave us these tags. So they know who we are if something happens.
Just keep it inside your blouse, honey. Chain's ugly.
Rosalie.
Do you have anything else to wear?
Well, it's what everyone wears.
Oh, honey, you're not everyone. You're special.
Okay, put your books away. Take out a pencil and a piece of paper and begin numbering.
Hey, Rose, that's by me. Freckle. Bayou. Codger. Environment.
Dollar's fine. I'm almost full now. Take a look at the back seat, Jack. I got the best spelling in the whole state of Nevada back there.
Hello, honey.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Mr. Chismore.
Hello, Robin.
You need any help?
Oh, no. Not today, Robin. Hey, Mosel.
Yeah?
Take a look.
What's that, Jack? What?
Not bad for an amateur, man. No, you don't like it?
No, it's. I don't like this A-bomb business.
Scientists know what they're doing.
I don't know.
Well, you'd prefer have a boy slaughtered in Korea than drop a few A-bomb tests?
Maybe you got a point.
There you go. You heard of the hydrogen bomb? They got a hydrogen bomb. Makes the A-bomb look like a firecracker.
It's a little tricky, Jack.
What's so funny?
You take the bottom.
Daddy. He has a bad leg.
You wouldn't think it was so funny if your dad got wounded in the war like Mr. Chismore.
I'm sorry.
I bet your father wasn't even in the war.
He was, too.
I suppose your dad's a big hero.
My dad's dead. He got killed in the war.
Bye.
Sure you don't want a cone, huh?
No, thanks.
Okay, kid.
Boy, it's hot out today.
Yeah, the thermometer at school said it was 79. I think it's a record.
You wanna go swimming tomorrow?
In December?
It's warm enough, why not?
Sure.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, bye.
I don't know how to swim.
Well, that's okay, honey. He asked you because he likes you, not because he thinks you're a great swimmer.
I don't have a bathing suit.
No bathing suits in Vegas, huh? Check that for runs.
Uncle Frank has a little boy, doesn't he?
Barbara Joe, he does not.
Uh-huh, I heard you tell Mama about it. What's his name?
His name is Matt, honey. And he's 5 years old, and he looks just like your Uncle Frank.
You can't have babies, can you?
No, honey, I can't have babies.
How come?
Rose, did you find a run in that one? Because it just came.
Hey, Rose, come on in.
I just ate. I don't want to get a cramp.
Try it. It's great.
Danica, Anne Marie.
It's freezing.
It's not either freezing.
It's too.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
I'd like you to meet some friends of mine. This is Ava and Tarzan's, my niece Rose.
Hi, Rose.
Hi.
You want to learn to swim?
Of course she does.
Talk to a girl at poolside, bearing your atomic hauteur while sipping an atomic octave. For the latest in atomic age fashion, the beautiful Las Vegas girl of today wears atomic age apparel to any affair, for a romantic evening, or for Las Vegas, but in the sun. Yes, our Las Vegas girl comes ready and well-equipped, but careful, fellas. Some of these girls are too hot to handle. Ooh, see what I mean?
Tarzan better stick with swinging in vines and swimming in the movies. He's not so out at ping pong.
Well, he's a good actor, though.
Yeah. I think it was just a stand-in, though.
He was?
Oh, of course.
He was not.
He was, too.
Was not.
Was, too.
Was not.
Like you know.
Yeah, I do. My Aunt Starr would not bring a stand-in.
Oh, uh-huh.
Been?
Swimming.
Has been granted by the city of Las Vegas. Federal and local civil defense authorities announced plans yesterday to blood test and type the entire population of Southern Nevada. Adult blood typing will be a
available at the Thunderbird Casino Tuesday afternoon and Thursday evening. So, come on down.
Daddy? Are you all right?
Honey, he's over the worst part. If he can keep off the booze, he'll be fine.
It's his nerves. You're shot. War, the station. All Jack needs is a rest. Even heroes have to rest. I told him, every path has its puddle, Daddy.
Sneaky, sneaky. Fremont Club, huh? How'd you do?
None of your beeswax?
How bad?
$315 markers.
Oh, Jesus. Well, they can't make you pay the markers.
If I was that kind of person, what do you think I'd do with a sick husband in the hospital who still thinks it's World War II every night? 42 days. That's all it'd take. But he's mine. Now, Deanne, honey, come in closer to your sister. That's it. Perfect. Who do they remind you of? The Andrews sisters.
Oh, yeah.
Would you like to hear him sing I've Got a Lovely Bunch of Coconuts?
Maybe later.
Okay. Rose, smile, honey. Look happy. Oh, it isn't any trouble, just ask Smiley. No, it isn't any trouble, just ask Smiley. That's it. But hold your head up, honey, because your nose looks better when you look up. Rose, honey, hold still and look at the camera. This is for Daddy.
Okay, girls, big smile now.
Perfect.
No wonder it doesn't work. You've got four dead tubes. Good luck.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
See you now.
A week had passed, and Jack was still in the hospital drying out. I was happy he was gone, and afraid he wouldn't come back.
Look what I found on the tree! Look what Santa brought!
What is it?
It's my new work badge. I had to take an oath and everything.
You got a new job?
I did, and it's the best in town. The biggest Christmas present of all. Daddy's coming home.
Goody!
Now, Daddy promised he'll never take a drink again. I know, he said it before. But remember when I was gambling all the time? I quit, didn't I? Well, if I can quit, so can Daddy. I told him how good you girls have been. And I told him that promises don't butter the bread. The proof is in the pudding. And Daddy said he just wants a chance to prove it.
Will you give Daddy a chance?
Would you spring a leak, kiddo, or are you just naturally wild like your Aunt Starr?
Naturally wild, I guess.
I wonder what makes somebody act mean. Sometimes I think he's the meanest man in the world.
He's not the meanest, honey.
Maybe there's just one little thing that if you knew what it was and you did it, it'd make the person happy. You know, like when a girl kisses a frog and the frog turns into a prince? Just have to know what it is.
Now, I want you to remember that Jack's probably gonna be a little nervous, so don't you be, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Okay, he's here.
People all over the country. Did you ever see a more handsome man in your life?
Well, once I did, yeah, in the movies.
Star for Star.
That's me.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, thank you. Merry Christmas to the most beautiful star sparkling in the heavens. Oh, my love, William. Isn't that sweet?
Beautiful.
Oh, my God. Oh, now, isn't that just the most beautiful thing you've ever seen?
Provide you as an attorney of that same.
I had many offers of attorneys, and one of those was from the American Civil Liberties Union, yes.
The question is, did the Civil Liberties Union supply you as an attorney?
They did supply an attorney.
The answer is yes. You know, the Civil Liberties Union has been listed as a front for and doing the work of the Communist Party.
Can I come in? Is it working okay?
Yeah, it's all right.
I got the tubes and everything. That's my present.
Don't mess around with it again, okay?
Talk to anybody, Daddy?
Boy, sure we're out of tune on bushels. I know I'm not the easiest person in the world to get along with. But A lot's happened. And I've had a chance to think things over last week or two. Come to the realization. My standards are too high. Can't expect everyone to be perfect. That's why I drank, out of frustration. Well, that's over and done with. From now on, I'm gonna be more easygoing. Who'd like to go for a drive out to Hoover Dam on Sunday?
I would, me!
Where the water's running free, and it's waiting there for you and me. Water, water, water,
water. Look at that. 7th man-made wonder of the world. 724 feet of poured concrete, 660 feet thick on the bottom, 45 feet across on top. The biggest concrete dam in the world. 4,400,000 cubic yards of cement. Enough cement, if you stacked it in 100-yard squares, it'd stand 2.5 miles high. Let's go see a generator.
30 feet, you can see, which are the generators. These units are 7 stories high. 40 feet below the generator floor level are the turbines, the rating of which is 115,000 horsepower. In all, there are 7 generating units in this wing of the power plant. The shaft you see through the lighted window of the first generator is 65 feet in length, 38 inches in diameter, and it weighs more than 100 tons.
The girl who gets all wrapped up in herself makes a mighty small package. Your father is trying to be nice. He's been through hell, and all you can think about is yourself. All right, if you can't be civil, then just go back and sit in the car. I'm disappointed in you, Rosalie Chismore.
Next to the atomic bomb, Hoover Dam is man's greatest engineering feat.
Come on, Rose, let's go. He's late again.
Well, maybe he won a lot of money last night.
I waited every morning for Mr. Mosel so he could tell me how smart I was and how I was a surefire bet to win the big county spelling bee.
Zoroastrianism.
Zoroastrianism.
Boy, you're really something. How'd you get so smart?
Charcoal beauties. Nice and hot.
Get the mustard, honey.
Well, at least you don't have to wear that silly uniform every day.
Oh, I know. I'm so glad. It's the best job I've had since basic magnesium back in the war. Pays twice what I got at the Cortez. And it's exciting being part of the bomb test and all. Isn't that exciting, your mama working for the AEC?
So when are they gonna drop the first one? Pretty soon?
Well, I don't know. It's a secret, Daddy. You know that. It said so in the papers and everything. I took an oath. My lips are sealed. I couldn't say anything if I knew, and I don't.
Well, I can find out easy enough. All I have to do is tune in the military channel. I probably know already, except I've been too busy to listen.
Oh, you're lucky I don't bet anymore, Daddy.
They're hiring like crazy, buddy.
Why don't you come to work for us? They need mechanics to run the generators, and you're the best in town.
I don't do casino work, and I don't do government work. I don't care what they pay.
I talked to Mr. Johnson about you, and he said he'd be happy to have you aboard, a war hero and all. I'm his secretary, and he's in charge of just about everything.
He can't be.
Well, he is.
Nope. Einstein, Oppenheimer, all of them are Jews. Wouldn't put a guy named Johnson in charge, he wouldn't have a prayer.
Daddy, do you think we should go in?
It's beautiful. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Rose? Come here. Who's playing?
Duke Ellington.
That's right. Duke Ellington, greatest composer since Beethoven. He's a nigger, Negro. Here. Listen. It's the only thing in the world that matters right there, even if the commies take over. You don't believe me, do you? What I said about things being different. That's okay. You don't know what I can do when I set my mind to it. The night I married your mother, you hit me over the head with a frying pan. Some honeymoon. Little nine-year-old girl had to climb up on a chair to hit her stepfather over the head with a frying pan. Sort of got us off on the wrong foot, didn't it? It took guts. I like that. You didn't understand. You thought you were protecting your mother. That's good. That's what I'm trying to do, protect my family. No hard feelings.
Huh? Hey. What do you think?
It's gorgeous.
You like it?
What about you, Jack? You think that Bill will like this?
Well, I can't speak for another man, but I like what I'm looking at.
White piano, white walls. He even has a white dog and a white cat. And he wears white pants and white shoes and has white...
Jitterbugs.
Honey, look in my eyes when we dance, because men like that sort of thing.
One, two, three.
Rose, you go to any nightclub they rent.
But I'm not going to a nightclub. I'm going to Meryl's dance party.
Okay.
Robin's the best dancer in Fifth Street School.
Well, you better hurry up. Yeah.
One, two,
see weather reports coming up in about 20 minutes. I don't want to miss it.
Tra-la-la, twiddly-dee-dee, it gives
me a thrill to wake up in the morning to the mockingbird's trill. Tra-la-la, twiddly-dee-dee, there's peace and goodwill. You're welcome as the flowers on Mockingbird Hill. When the sun in the morning peeps over the hill and kisses the roses round my windowsill, then my heart fills with gladness when I hear the trill of the birds in the treetops on Mockingbird Hill. Tra-la-la, twiddly-dee-dee, it gives me a thrill to wake up in the morning to the mockingbird's trill. Tra-la-la, twiddly-dee-dee, there's peace and goodwill. You're welcome as the flowers on Mockingbird Hill.
My leg's gone.
Jack was like tossing a coin. You never knew which side was going to come up. I couldn't wait to brag to Shelley what a good dancer he was. Only she was so busy griping about her dad, I didn't get a chance.
No wonder my mom's divorced him 4 times.
You know, Rita's parents got divorced 16 times. Sometimes I have to call the courthouse just to see if they're married or not.
The war in Korea was getting worse, and Las Vegas was turning into a military camp.
I can't raise anybody. What should I do? I'm doing what I can. God damn it.
You're home, Jack.
No one answers. Get down! Get down!
There's no snow here. There's no snow.
Mama.
Can I put the blanket around you, honey? Can I? Can I put it on you? Can I? I'm gonna get the blanket on you now, okay?
Fall off, will it? Shouldn't we have straps or something on it?
No, honey, it won't fall off. It just shows off those beautiful shoulders. Now turn around, Rosalie. Okay, come back. Okay. Okay, there.
Well, it's not half bad.
Now I think we just need a little something on top to kind of balance things out.
Oh, no, not after what happened last time.
I'll put double stitches, honey, I promise.
No, I don't want to, I don't...
Rose, do you want to look good?
But what if I lose them again?
I'll sew them in tight.
Start.
Shh, hush.
Conditions holding. Winds above ground zero, light west, 18 knots.
Look like anti-aircraft guns, and they don't look droopy. It's just right.
Rose!
Yes, sir?
What did you do to my radio?
Nothing. I didn't do anything.
You've been in my room, haven't you?
No.
You're lying. Go to your room.
I didn't do anything. Star's not finished fitting my dress.
You don't need a dress. You're not going anywhere.
That's not fair.
What did you say to me?
It's not fair.
Go to your room.
No.
Go to your room.
It's not fair.
She's being disciplined.
She's 13 years old, for Christ's sake.
Nothing dries faster than a tear. See? All gone. Your daddy left awful upset, honey.
I hope he goes away and never comes back. He's not my daddy.
Don't say that, honey. You don't mean that.
Starts drinking again, we'll go to a motel. He wouldn't have done it if he had been sober. He wouldn't have. Remember the night Daddy had the bad nightmare? That's what makes him drink. Nightmares and bad memories. Someday they'll just go away. They will. I'm sorry, honey. I gotta get back to work. I'll get in touch if I don't. Okay.
There you go. Good as new. You check it every now and then, and if it starts to show through, put these on. You say you got your ass checked, nobody will know the difference. It's good for crying and bruises and hangovers and insomnia and illicit rendezvous.
Let's see what the next one is.
It's more like it.
You must be a movie star.
I just had my eyes tested, so I have to wear these.
Everything okay at home?
Fine.
Sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Wanna dance?
If you need anything, anytime, you come see me or Mrs. Mosel, okay?
Okay.
fight the war to win in Korea, rather than try to settle at the diplomatic table, which is impossible when you're dealing with Russia.
Mr. Van Zandt, would you extend your will to win so far as to include the atomic bomb?
Very definitely, Dr. Peterson. I've always been a firm believer that we should use the atomic bomb, not only on Korea, but north of the Yalu River in Manchuria. That is, we could destroy them with the atomic bomb, we could destroy them and contaminate them.
It's okay, honey. It's just me.
So, did you have a good time? Are you still in the Pink Pinky Club?
Yep. Star, when you get married, can I come live with you?
He hasn't asked me.
He will.
Go to sleep.
In an A-bomb, they bombard the nucleus with electrons and split the atom. Matter changes into energy. Pay attention to what I'm saying. It's all this book here. Read up on the book. You mean to tell me you work for the AEC? You don't even know what E equals MC squared means? E equals energy. M stands for the mass. E stands for the velocity of light. Get it?
I've got to get to work, Jack.
Oh, working Saturdays. Oh, something must be up, Lil, huh? You should read up on this stuff, Lily. Is it right here? Great thinker's book. It's all in here. They thought he was retarded, but he wasn't retarded.
Come eat your cereal, honey.
Albert Einstein.
Jon Starr up yet?
In an A-bomb, they bombard the nucleus with electrons, split the atom. Matter changes into energy. That's the whole deal in a nutshell. Ask your Mr. Goldstein.
Johnson. Mr. Johnson.
They thought he was retarded. Wasn't retarded. It was the opposite of retarded. He was a genius. Albert Einstein.
Morning. Are you trying to make a liar out of me? I have to sign a piece of paper that says you lived here every day. It's the law, and I have to swear to it, or you don't get your divorce.
I'm sorry, Lil. It won't happen again.
Well, I should hope not.
I'll get it.
Hi, Jack. Is the little lady in? I'd like to talk to her a minute, if it's okay.
Lily, it's for you.
Hi, kids.
Hi, Mr. Mosel.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
No, I can only stay a minute. I guess you know when they're gonna drop it, huh?
That's classified, Mr. Mosel. You shouldn't even ask me that.
If you could get at all the power that's in the atoms in this salt shaker, pay attention. You never have to buy gas the rest of your life.
It's just that I'd really like to know when it's going to be, because I'd like to send my wife and my daughter to Los Angeles for a few days.
Mr. Mosel, the bus trip is more dangerous than the A-bomb.
Just call the airlines. Flights to Reno are canceled. That's when it'll blow.
Well, don't tell anyone I told you. I haven't even told Jack yet. There's a light above the AEC office. Uh-huh. If it's green, it means there'll be a test within 24 hours. If I were you, Mr. Mosel, I'd check it every day starting tomorrow.
Oh.
Star.
It's me. I'm making a wish.
Hey,
inside the limits of the Las Vegas bombing and gunnery range may be subject to injury or death. Warning posters have been distributed in towns adjacent to the range, and air patrols have commenced around the test site perimeter.
I gotta go to Los Angeles on the bus tonight. My dad's making me. He thinks the A-bomb's going off tomorrow. Isn't it dumb?
I guess so.
You leave right after the spelling bee. I hope you win.
Thanks.
Good luck, Rose.
Okay, I'll see you. Bye.
Bye.
Mama planned a surprise divorce party to cheer Star up. I came home to help with the decorations before the spelling bee. I'd made it to the county finals.
Bottle. Ow!
Jack, stop!
And now I present the finalists in the 11th annual Clark County Championship Spelling Bee. May the best speller win.
Kid on the rail for $10. $20 says the tall girl with the braids wins it.
You're on.
The first word is chauffeur.
Chauffeur. Chauffeur. C-H-A-U-F-F-E-U-R.
That's correct.
It's the fastest 20 I ever made.
Emissary.
Emissary. E-M-I-S-S-A-R-Y.
That's correct. Unsuberized.
Unsuberized. U-N-S-U-B-E-R-Z-I-E-D.
That's misspelled. Hypothesis.
Hypothesis. H-Y-P-O-T-H-E-S-I-S.
That's correct. Potpourri.
Potpourri. P-O-T-P-O-U-R-R-I.
That's correct. Syzygy.
I couldn't spell it.
Syzygy. S-Y-Z-Y-G-Y.
That's correct. Apiarian.
Apiarian. A-P-I-A-R-I-A-N.
Correct. Sanguine.
S-A-N-G-U-I-N.
That's incorrect. Kurzimer.
That's a puppy.
Kurzimer. K-E-R-S-E-Y-M-E-R-E.
That's correct.
Oh, great.
Jodhpur.
Jodhpur. J-O-D-H-P-U-R.
That's correct.
Oh, he's a toughie, that kid.
I know.
Chaparral.
Chaparral. C-H-A-P-A-R-R-A-L.
That's correct. Mensch.
Mensch. M-E-N-C-H-E.
No way. I know.
That's incorrect, but would you please have a seat? Mensch.
Could you repeat the word, please?
Mitch.
M-E-N-S-C-H.
That's correct.
Please don't be mad at me, Rose. It wasn't what you thought. We were just kidding around.
Tell Mom I went to Grandma's.
Suitcase.
I don't want to live here anymore. I want to go to Grandma's.
Go to your room, girls. Go on, go on. What makes you say such a terrible thing, Rose Chismore?
She's just excited. She won the spelling bee this afternoon.
What spelling bee?
Clark County Finals. She's the best speller in Las Vegas.
Honey, that's wonderful. But it's no reason to run away. Rose. It's not because of the other day, is it, honey, when you made Daddy mad?
It's not why.
Well, then why?
Every kid runs away. It's just life. Don't get worked up about it and spoil the night for everybody. It's not every day you get to see an A-bomb go off. It's history.
My mushroom soup. What are you doing with my mushroom soup? Jack? Jack, my little girl is running away, my baby. Why? Jack and I had a couple of drinks, Lil, and Rose got the wrong idea. Go to your room, Rose. Thought you were so special with your rich Texan. Nothing special. Las Vegas is full of whores. You're probably the only one in Vegas who'd spread her legs for a couple of dozen roses. I want you out of here. Do you hear me? Now! You want a child of your own, huh? What a laugh! How can you have a child?
Shut up!
Big war hero shooting blanks! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Please! Stop it! Stop it!
Everything okay here?
We'll be all set in jiffy, Mr. Mosley. You're just a little early, that's all.
You okay?
Excuse me. Pardon me.
Hi, Jack. What kind of gun you got there. Hey, Nick, take a look at this rifle. It's a real beauty, isn't it?
Yeah, sure is.
What is that, Jack? Is that German?
41W, semi-automatic. It is a beauty, isn't it? Listen to this. Krauss could make a weapon. You gotta give him that.
It's a beauty, all right.
Did you tell these people about tomorrow morning? Do they know?
I put Merrill and Mrs. Mosel on the bus tonight for Los Angeles. And I didn't tell anybody why, I swear.
I'm set up to monitor everything. Wind velocity, direction, barometric pressure. If the wind blows the wrong way, I'll know. Russians try something, I'll hear it on the short wave. I even got a Geiger counter from Army surplus. Main thing is to keep the morale up. Can I count on you?
Sure thing, sure.
Jack, Lily, come on, I want you to meet some friends of mine. Nick from Miami, Lenny from New York, and Faye and Flame. They dance at the Flamingo. Great artists.
Hello, Faye and Flame. Well, I think I'll go freshen up. Oh, well, don't just stand there, honey. Why don't you offer our guests some cake? Would you like some cake?
26 January, 1900 hours. Conditions holding. Winds above ground zero, light from west. 10,000 feet, 30 knots, 20,000.
If I see another bruise on Rose, I'm coming after you. I just wanted you to know. I don't care how many guns you've got.
So, do you sing, too?
Yeah, we do.
Oh, that's great. My girls sing, you know. Rose, why don't you play You Are My Sunshine for Faye and Flame? They're entertainers. No? Well, how about I've Got a Lovely Bunch of Coconuts? Well, I guess if nobody else is gonna play, I guess I have to. Honey, you want a little ice cream on your cake?
No.
You can't go all the way to Reno by yourself.
Would you come with me?
To Reno? In the middle of the night? You can't go on the desert like that.
I can too.
Hey, wait a minute. I won't let you go. It's too dangerous.
Let go. Go!
Rose!
Let go!
Rose! Rose, you can't. It's 800 miles away.
Reno?
Las Vegas is here. Reno is up here.
You're not going to stay out here all night. You watch, that's your business.
Go back then. See if I care.
Jeez.
Where are you headed?
Reno?
Hop in.
Thirty miles outside Las Vegas, we heard the radio announcement. The road to Reno was closed. No one but military could get through.
Let's stay by the highway.
They'll see us. You want to get caught? Come on, let's go.
Well, not that way. That's the bombing range.
It is not. That's the bombing range on the other side.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. It's gonna be cold.
Just dip the tuna into the mushroom soup. See, it's good.
Well, your dad's gonna be mad.
If I have kids, I won't ever hit them. The soldiers downtown, they're going to Korea, aren't they?
Yeah.
Will you visit me at my grandma's sometimes?
Well, you're not gonna live there all the time, are you?
I don't know. I'm glad you're here. I'd be really scared if you weren't. Anybody else would have gone back to Las Vegas and left me out here. You're probably the only boy in Fifth Street School that wouldn't.
Officer, I'm her father. You've done a good job.
I have to get clearance for you to take custody.
Why don't you guys go fight the communists instead of picking on a 13-year-old girl?
Come on.
My glasses are out there.
Hey, hey, you can't go out there. Stop!
I never expected him to actually go look for my glasses. Jack was full of surprises. My real father left when I was six. Deanne and Barbara Joe barely remember him. He drove off one morning and never came back. and there was no more chance to try harder or even ask him why.
You probably like me about as much as I like my father. I haven't seen him since I was 15.
You're not my father.
No, I'm not. I haven't been much of a substitute either. But I'm here. I really want to protect you.
Protect us from who?
I've never forgiven anybody in my life. If you could.
Nick Hansen?
I guess your old Aunt Starr can still turn their heads a little, huh?
Starr, it's the last dance, and I'm feeling awful lonely out here.
Rose and I are having a little talk.
Makes it tough on a guy.
Go on. Starr?
Starr finally found a man who adored her. They live in Glendale, and Starr does portraits on black velvet.
Rose?
Thanks.
For fixing the radio. I'm the one that should go to Reno. You'd all be better off. I just want you to know that I'm very proud of you. Well, that was something, wasn't it? Making those AEC guys wait while I went and found your glasses.
Things never came easy for Jack, but the worst times were over. Mama kept on seeing what she wanted to see.
Sorry, fellas.
Every cloud had a silver lining.
Keep playing. One more hand. Exactly
3 minutes. Daddy? White light. Come look, the bomb's about to go. The desert silence will be broken by the awesome roar and rumble of an atomic detonation. Nevada residents will witness the
rise and shine. It's a bomb time.
Of a nuclear detonation.
It's beautiful.
Survivors, this is Radio Kino, Las Vegas. Well, the A-bomb went off and we're all still here, folks.